Shifting gears now to that forecast and what Milton is looking like right now.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. Here's a live view Earth cam from Englewood Beach. This is going to be where we see some of our highest surge here later on this evening. Water has been slowly coming up, but Milton just off the coast there of that camera shot. That camera shot was about right there. The core of Milton is sitting about right here. Notice following along our line fairly well. This is the center of the cone, which brings the center in around the Sarasota area later on this evening as a hurricane. Now you can see they're already getting tropical storm conditions along the coastal areas. There's been multiple confirmed fairly large tornadoes, still ongoing tornado warnings all over the place. So that's the initial threat with Milton, but then eventually the winds, the flooding rains, and then the surge coming in on the south side. And remember, the surge will be highest anywhere from the center to the south where those winds are being pushed on shore. So if this eye stays just south of Tampa, Tampa does not have big surge. It's a very close call, but if that eye comes in south, Tampa will be okay. If that eye wobbles north, that's where you get your historic storm surge. So here's the official cone, taking it in just near Tampa or Fort Myers, somewhere in there. And remember, these things do wobble around. This thing is also encountering a lot of wind shear, so the structure of it's changing. And you may see it get pulled in a different direction here and there as it moves inland. But those little wobbles, they do matter. And for those in Tampa, certainly they're not letting their guard up just yet. And hopefully they have evacuated if they were told to. At this point, it's getting a little too late. This is at about 11 o'clock tonight. The storm should have made landfall by then, and then those hurricane force winds will stretch across really along I-4 here, which is right here. The initial threat, tornadoes. This is a fairly significant tornado threat this afternoon. Eventually, that threat will become more from hurricane force winds and storm surge and flooding rain. This is the corridor of hurricane force winds right in here. The red and purples where you have power outages likely. That does include Orlando, Tampa down to Fort Myers, and north of Miami. Miami's way down here, so no major problems there up to Fort Pierce. Now the storm surge, once again, 10 to 15 feet near the center and south. If the storm stays south of Tampa, they do not see the 8-12 feet of storm surge. If it gets closer, you may see that 12 to 15 feet of storm surge. But right now, these same areas that were hit so hard by Hurricane Ian 2 years ago are looking like very similar levels with storm surge. I've got a couple scenarios. If the storm comes in where we're forecasting it near Sarasota, which is there, you could see all this red. That is water coming 9 to 12 to even nearly 12 to 15 feet up, and it gets funneled into these areas, these bays, and these are essentially kind of like bayou areas. Port Charlotte could get really hard hit. Fort Myers again could get very hard hit. Now, this is the scenario if it travels closer to Tampa. This would be the catastrophic scenario if it wobbles to the north. You've got 12 to 15 to maybe 20 feet of storm surge in Tampa Bay here. And remember, this is all populated area. That's the airport. If it wobbles to the north, it all goes underwater. But once again, if it stays south, then no big surge in Tampa Bay. Also, a lot of rain going to fall in the northern eyewall here from Tampa to Orlando, up to a foot of rainfall in the forecast. Once again, that's what it looks like, a live picture from the coastal areas there right off Florida. Now, the storm itself is going to be moving out. It'll be in the Atlantic by tomorrow afternoon. And then the attention turns to a decent cool front coming down into our area next week. So our forecast looking great here. I really don't have much to talk about locally, which we are grateful for. We will have cool mornings the next 7 days. Our mornings are looking great in the 50s and 60s, afternoons in the 80s with a lot of sunshine, and then a stronger cold front gets here next Tuesday. Notice we have highs in the 70s, and much of next week looks like highs in the 70s. Might even see a few 40s on the North Shore and 50s on the South Shore. Heads up for boaters. It will be choppy today and tomorrow, but things look smoother on Friday. Your high tide was this morning and your low tides this afternoon.